After
7 o'clock.
3 hour drive, we landed, we're in the airport at 3 o'clock.
Got the rental car, by 4 o'clock we were out of the rental car company.
We were on the highway. We started going on the highway and it took 3 hours to get here. No, it was 4 o'clock, because it's 3 hours. It's 7 o'clock we got here. And I can tell you, it's only 70 miles, 3 hours. And that last hour and a half was darn right scary.
More night driving.
Night driving is sucks, because people are just walking along the road. It's really scary. So we're gonna enjoy a nice evening here.
That's okay.
It's nice to finally get here. Beautiful, beautiful place. Absolutely stunning.
More to come.
Yep.
It's raining cats and dogs now. It's a rainforest, baby. Look at that. Come down. Woo! Honey, do you like rain?
I do. As long as I can stay dry. Like here. And drink my wine.
Oh, they're friends. That's so sweet. Very interesting lizard, but it's in the water. Hot water. Variable seed eater. Female.
What was your favorite bird of the day, dear?
Oh, it's so hard because I had so many new life birds. I had kind of three of them.
What was that? Pale rump?
The buff rump warbler.
I watched him
for a long time trying to figure out what the heck he was. So I finally figured it out.
That was a great bird.
Good bird.
Yeah, that was enjoyable.
Pretty bland though. So I would have to say my next favorite was the Arcara. Because he was like really colorful.
Yeah, he was really colorful. I was expecting to see more of them. We saw like some of them fly by,
right.
and that was it.
So that was a good one.
Yeah.
I like the Trogon, the violaceous Trogon. That was very pretty bird. That was a very pretty bird and very cooperative. So that was kind of nice. And I saw him first, so that's always fun when I get to see him first. And then the last bird of the day that I saw, the Carasso, something like that. Those are cool. Turkeys on steroids.
And which was better, the prettier, the
female?
Female was actually prettier than the male.
Yeah,
female was amazing. It was a really great bird. So that's it for this evening. We're gonna have a little bit of libations here and
drink our complimentary bottle of wine that was very gracious and generous, along with our chocolate truffles and strawberries. Those are pretty amazing too. I ate them all. We hit some rough road. We're now on a dirt road with lots of hot holes and big ditches and divots, and actually it's improved quite a bit.
Was it 12 miles or 17 miles to go on this road to Monteverde?
Yes, 17 more miles to go to Monteverde. And how long is it going to take us, Chuck?
Hi, Jay.
So today is January 13th. It's Monday. We just left La Fortuna area this morning.
The Tabacon Thermal Resort and Spa.
Yep.
Highly recommended if you want someplace posh.
If you have money to burn.
Or not, burn it for but you want to burn it.
They'll burn it for you.
Yes, they will burn it for you.
Got up at 5 a.m., which is 6 a.m. Eastern time. Quickly heard a pygmy owl of some sort, either Costa Rican or Phryginus. Opened the, went on our patio, started calling with a tape. It actually came fairly close. We never could see it. It was so thick, we couldn't see it. But went outside, birded a little bit, went to a great breakfast. The breakfasts are gratis there, incredible, big spread.
Almost as good as Europe. Not quite, but almost.
Yep. And then we went down to the hot springs. Water temperature is somewhere between 93 and 98, somewhere in that range. Took some great pictures, pictures and video of Terri doing some yoga in the water and some other places down there, beautiful scenes. Came back, we noticed on our walk, it's about 150 yards to there, we noticed on our walk, good bird activity, so we came back, got showered up, came back, tried to get some more birds. We did get some birds in that area. Pretty nice. Came back to the hotel, packed up, got in the car. This place, Monte Verde area, is about 17 miles as the crow flies. Or actually, I think it's less.
I think it's like 12 as the crow flies.
But almost 3 hour drive because you have to drive around a lake and...
Lake Arenal, around the volcano.
42 miles. Almost 3 hours, very treacherous at times. Mm-hmm. About half of it paved, maybe less. The stone roads are very windy, up and down. Some areas only one lane wide, so if a truck was coming, there's tour buses. It just blows me away, tour buses coming through here on these rocky roads, single lane bridges. Unbelievable. I would be totally sick if we had taken a tour bus.
Makes Michigan dirt roads look good.
Yeah. So, got it really difficult. Once we got in town, we were having trouble. Google Maps, every type of map. Right. We couldn't find the place we are at tonight. It's only got 8 cabins. It's really very quaint. Tucked away from the main drag. And the only way we found it, because there's no street addresses.
No street sign.
Anywhere in Costa Rica. No street signs. So Terri just happened to look down a stone road and saw a sign about this big, and it was the shape of the sign she had seen when she signed up for this place, Expedia or whatever we chose. So that's the only way she knew. She showed me the picture. That looked right. So we drove back here. Then we could see the sign. It was hand-painted about letters about that tall. Otherwise, we would have never found this place. We found this place. It's actually very quaint. Have a tree house essentially to our ourselves. It's beautiful, so.
It's really a nice little place tucked in. The people are friendly. Marcos, the young man who checked us in and showed us our cabin. Perfect English. He just was a really nice guy. I mean, took care of us well, very accommodating, and told us we were to get ready for a nice fat breakfast in the morning.
We'll so see. We'll for see now. We're drinking our dinner.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers.
We are in what is this? Santa Ana?
Santa Elena.
Santa Elena?
Forest, yeah.
This forest is amazing. With our guide?
Daner.
Daner. He is awesome. And the vegetation here is so dreamy. So lush. Got a lot of species already. They're very fleeting. Tough to see. But incredible morning.
And our guide knows the calls.
Yeah, that makes it way easier.
It's buzzing by.
You see it? No. Which hummingbird is this?
Oh, yeah, I got it. It just flew up.
Which hummingbird is this?
Green.
Brown breeding hummingbird.
Nice tree runner there.
A little bit of spotting on his throat.
Spot it.
Yes, that's the one. Spotted.
Tree creeper.
Tree runner here.
There's a tree creeper.
We have a tree runner here. Shanks, tree child. Two of them.
Male, female. You know, they're all the raptors, they're monogamous, so they live together. All the raptors, owls, falcons, eagles. And they hunt at nighttime, but separately. So they sleep together, but at nighttime, so they split, right? So that's characteristic of raptors, birds, well, mice, rats, so that's the favorite food of them. Sometimes they hunt some snakes at night, but only at night. So in the day, you can see it. So actually, it's easier to see it in the day if we know the place where they sleep, right? Because at night, it will be moving very fast. They're not that big, so it's a little harder. But
big screech owl.
Kind of, yeah.
Yeah, it's much larger than
our trees. Mm-hmm. Those are our house plant trees. They don't get like this.
Incredible. Wow.
And it's got other like bromeliad type trees growing on it too and stuff.
Bromelias, orchids, philodendron.
We're at the restaurant at the St. Helena Forest and common Chlorospingus are basically the house sparrows here. They're like getting underneath the picnic tables looking for food. Which tanager is this? Spectacled cheeked? Hold on, Terri. It's a yellowish flycatcher. That's actually the name of it.
That's female, which
female
one is that?
Female purple-throated mountain gem. Magenta, no.
Never told me I could do this. So what's on my hand right now?
Green chrome brilliant.
Okay.
Coppery headed. This is endemic.
The coppery-headed
animal is endemic.
Oh my god, he's so tiny. Get out of here, wasp.
Do you have endemic species in your hand?
Yeah.
Purple-throated mountain gem, male.
I think this is one that I was thinking because it's real green, but it looks real black. Mm-hmm. So it looks real black. Yeah, purple-throated mountain gem.
So the purple
gem,
here?
Yeah.
We saw the female.
Mm-hmm.
This is the one I meant that looked really
okay.
Black.
Uh-huh.
I didn't know I could put them on my finger.
Actually, correction, it's a brown jay. Two of them. Two brown jays. Rufus Moore.
Stop anywhere, pick people up.
first. Really have to watch your step in here, in this parking lot. Almost stepped on one of these guys. And they're pretty big, too.
So, yesterday, let's talk about yesterday first.
Busy day.
It was all about birding. We had Daner for how many hours?
3 in the morning and 4 in the afternoon.
Okay.
3 in the afternoon.
Yeah, we got a lot of birds. We were tired. We were very tired. We took them out to dinner afterwards. What were the highway birds?
So 72 for the day.
No, it was 90. It was 90 something. Anyway, you're right. 72.
I thought it was 72 for the day.
But the thing is, there was some amazing, amazing birds. So, what was the best bird of the day? I can't recall.
Most people would say the resplendent quetzal. Not for us. We're not about showy birds. We're about like cool, challenging birds.
Yep.
So like the silvery tinnitus or whatever, that little thing.
Okay, silvery throated tanager was amazing.
Yeah, that was a good one. But I'm talking about the guy on the ground.
The brush finch. Yes. Okay. But let's talk about.
Wait, I remember. We'll have to look it up.
Okay. So we did get later in the day in the parking lot. We did get the yellowish flycatcher also.
Yeah. That was a good bird.
So and then we went to another park where you had some amazing video of hummingbirds.
Hummingbirds. They land on your finger. It's awesome.
Feeding on her finger. That was incredible.
Yeah, that was fun.
So much fun. And then, so we got up this morning. Our place that we had was beautiful.
But it was so windy.
It was so
windy. You couldn't sleep at night. It was like
very
the trees
windy.
Were going to come through the glass and like just wake
very
us up.
Very windy. So then we went from windy to
beach.
So we drove in the car. We went to, what was the name of the park?
Carrara National Park.
Carrara. And we got incredible videos of puffbird, and then we got collared forest fart, falcon, there's something else.
Scarlet macaw.
Scarlet macaws, yeah.
And a spotted ant bird. I don't remember.
Yeah,
it was a little
black
bird with a little.
We got an ant wren. We did get an ant wren, spotted ant wren. Yep, that was incredible. And then came to here. It took about 2 hours since then to get to Manuel Antonio. And this place is incredible. It's absolutely incredible. The room and everything we have. Oh!
Wet feet, shoot. Now my sandals are all wet, but that's okay, they'll dry.
So incredible. So anyway.
I do have a lot of chigger bites from yesterday. My whole body is encased in chigger bites.
Yeah, that was
especially
a little rough.
The armpits.
She's just showing her muscle, that's
no,
all.
No, it's bad. I itch so terribly, but it's all chiggers because of where they're located.
It's very dreamy.
It's
I love this place.
Yeah.
Absolutely love it. That's it for today, thanks.
Yeah.
Got it.
Le raton laveur.
Female. Which one, Terri?
Black
hood. Female black hood. Prettier than the male. Male is calling behind it. tipped dove here.
It is our final full night at Manuel Antonio. I haven't been drinking.
Maybe just a little bit.
We actually do head back toward San Jose tomorrow. A little bit of a pura vida day today.
Pura vida.
Very relaxed. Started out earlier than we have been. We started out, the park doesn't open until 7. We got there about 7:15. Walked through the park. It was a little quieter today than yesterday. There were a lot of neotropical migrants. There were three red starts, a lot of chestnut-sided warblers, a Tennessee warbler. There was
gray-crested flycatcher.
Couple Philadelphia vireos, so a lot of friendly faces. but we did have some highlight birds. We had fiery-billed
Arikari, which was very pretty.
Yep. Yeah. Took another trail we didn't take yesterday and got a golden
crown
tanager. New for the trip.
It was a fleeting moment for me.
Yes, it's hard to point out for. And then later in the day we had
toucans again, which was fun. A couple toucans.
We did take a night walk. Saw some. Actually started out, it was starting to get dark and we had an orange-billed sparrow, which is really, really cool and totally unexpected, really dark when we saw it, but we were able to get lights on it and stuff, a pair. Took another little night walk, there were frogs everywhere. We really wanted to steer clear of the snakes.
Yeah, step on one of those things
called
fertilance, stuff
that kills you.
It just kind of eats your like flesh away, and then like you could lose an arm or a leg by the time you make it to the hospital. So.
Right. But lots of frogs on the trail. We did get a sloth. I mean, we've gotten sloths sleeping, but this one we saw up in the tree scratching itself on our night hawk.
Cool.
But we spent a bunch of time in the pool and the ocean today, just having fun in the ocean. It was great. So a little bit of our last day being a little bit more carefree and how you call in this country, pura vida.
Pura vida.
So we'll sign off till next tomorrow night, right?
Tomorrow night while we wrap up our trip.
Okay.
Stopped along the road here and there's a bunch of lapwings in this field along with cattle grads, but so we're at the hotel, Hampton Inn. We're at the Hampton Inn at the airport.
Hey.